Last year, 100 million people tuned in live to Miss World. More viewers than for the moon landings or the World Cup final.
Beautiful, darling.
Mum, don't. You and your sisters used to love playing Miss World.
I also like to eat our own snot.
We really believe beauty isn't just skin deep. The girls also have charm, grace, good deportment.
Swimsuits.
Miss World rehearsals are underway.
I'm the first black South African to take part.
I'm the first Miss Grenada.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Bob Hope.
The last time Bob guested on this show, he brought the winning girl home with him.
They're turning oppression into spectacle. Let's make a spectacle of our own. We'd infiltrate the theatre.
We've just been smoking and watching like in a heist film.
If I win, there will be little girls who might start to believe they have a place in the world.
We're black. We're not going to be Miss World.
You don't own me.
I don't want you to think I'm some kind of brute that doesn't consider the feelings of women. I consider feeling women all the time.
Get this.
Tonight may be the start of something, Bob.
This competition makes us compete with each other and makes the world narrower for all of us in the end. Why should any woman have to earn her place in the world by looking a particular way?
You don't. He doesn't. Why should we?
So when did women first start directing movies? Earlier than you might imagine, Alice Guy Blaché was the first woman to direct a movie back in 1896 with The Fairy of the Cabbages, which sadly has been lost since its creation. Incredibly, this is also considered to be the first ever narrative film. Over her lifetime, she founded her own studio, Solex Studios. She directed between 40 and 50 films and supervised nearly 300 other productions. Wow. If you like my show, get one for yourself in the link in the description.